We offer courses in English, language, arts and culture. And we are expertise in English language teaching and exams delivery. So that is the role of British Council in India. So now moving on to IELTS. So let me ask you, what do you guys know about IELTS? Any idea? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. International exam? Yes, that's right. Anybody else? IELTS, as the name suggests, is International English Language Testing System. Any non-native English speaker like you and me, if we want to go abroad, this is a test to prove your proficiency in the language. So if you are intending a career abroad, if you want to migrate to a different country, you want to live there, you want to study there, you will need to take this test to prove your proficiency in the English language. This test is administered by the University of Cambridge, and British Council is a proud co-owner of this test, and we deliver this test worldwide. Yeah? Now I'm going to play another video which will give you an idea about IELTS. Then we'll talk about it.
IELTS is the International English Language Testing System, provides proven English language tests. IELTS was one of the pioneers of four skills English language testing over 21 years ago and continues to set the standard for English language testing today.
The IELTS standard is in collaboration by the University of Cambridge, one of the most prestigious universities in the world, so I have no doubt about this.
IELTS is one tool to test all the four skills of language, so it gives an accurate measurement to someone's proficiency of English.
I needed English qualification for my master degree, so it should be IELTS. This is like the passport to every institution.
And for 8,000 organizations and more than 2 million test takers around the world, trust and recognize IELTS as a secure, valid, and reliable indicator of trips and ability to communicate in English for education, immigration, and professional accreditation.
So operations are the same in every single test center, every single testing location, for every single candidate.
Because it is a global standard, and any candidate who does an IELTS speaking test, it should be the same experience, the same rating, the same procedure, whether it's in Moscow, or Brazil, or Australia, or whatever.
It's very professional procedures that have to be secure, even if they don't have mobiles and everything that they can use for illegal purposes.
So we feel very confident that our proposal is going to be this kind of mechanical operating test.
Now when I came here, everything was very easy. I mean, people were very friendly and kind. I mean, they contacted all the information for me, and this was just where I can check it.
When I registered the IELTS was free, the B6 was free.
And reliable indicator of trips and ability to communicate in English for education, immigration, and professional accreditation.
The operations are the same in every single test center, every single testing location, for every single candidate.
Because it is a global standard, and any candidate who does an IELTS speaking test, it should be the same experience, the same rating, the same procedure, whether it's in Moscow, or Brazil, or Australia, or whatever.
It's very professional procedures that have to be secure, even if they don't have mobiles or anything that they can use for illegal purposes.
We feel very confident that our proposal is going to be secure, this kind of technology will get the test.
Now when I came here, everything was very easy. I mean, people were really friendly and kind. I mean, they contacted all the information for me, and this was just where I can check it.
When I registered the IELTS was free, the B6 hours, and the local finals.
It was actually really easy to find the test of the hours to do every day. So we were looking at a new chance.
Initially, IELTS tests English conversation skills through a face-to-face speaking test, which questions that candidates are assessed by having a conversation with a real person. This is the most effective and natural way of testing English conversation skills.
So I can go to other tests. I feel better with the speaking part than if I'm speaking somewhere and I'm doing it.
For candidates, IELTS is a true indicator of their eligibility and gives greater professional and academic mobility. More people go more places with IELTS.
So as I told you already, IELTS is the English language test administered by the University of Cambridge, and British Council is the proud co-owner of IELTS, and we deliver this test worldwide. IELTS is accepted in over 10,000 organizations in 140 countries across the world. Organizations, I mean the universities, the companies offering you the job. If you want a life abroad, if you want to study, you want to migrate, you want to live in a foreign country, you will need to take this test to prove your proficiency in the English language. So now, tell me, why do you think 10,000 organizations accept this test? Not two countries agree on a concept, but why do you think 140 countries have agreed this as a mark, as a benchmark of English proficiency? Any reasons that you want to think of? Standard, very good, yes, then. Quality, yes, then. Sorry. Some answers from the girls as well. Girls are all very quiet in your college. Anything that you can think of. So now, let me ask you this way. How do you think you're assessed in an interview? Say that you're taking an interview. How do you think you're marked on your communication skills? No idea? Okay, it's generally by the way you converse with the person who's interviewing you. Okay, however you talk, however you present yourself in the interview, that is how you are assessed on your communication skills. So now let's say it wasn't your day. You were late for the interview, you were stuck in a traffic jam, you had a fight with your mom that day morning. So something disturbed you and you were not able to strike an efficient conversation with the person interviewing you. And let's say you're a person with moderate communication skills, you are able to manage with your communication skills. But this person marks you down, okay, rates you down on your communication. So do you think this is fair? Yes? Yes or no?
No.
So just by assessing your level of communication by the way you converse is not the right thing to do. It doesn't give you any practical or accurate results. But IELTS is accepted as a benchmark of language proficiency in 10,000 organizations around 140 countries in the world because we test in four language skills of English, which is listening, reading, writing, and speaking. We test you on all the four skills, give you a score for each skill, as well as give you an overall band score. So the results are more practical and accurate. And that is the reason that IELTS is accepted in more than 10,000 organizations. The flagship feature of IELTS is a one-on-one speaking test with an examiner. Usually in these English language proficiency tests available, other than IELTS, there are lots of tests available in the market. It's like you talk to a computer. The speaking remains like you talk to a computer. The computer would say, now, record your conversation after the beep. And there's a beep, you go blank. So you just forget what to talk because of your anxiety levels. That's what generally happens. But whereas in IELTS, there's a human examiner who will welcome you, will make you sit, talk to you, tell you that the conversation is being recorded. Now let's start the interview. And that's how you're assessed. So the way you converse, the way you speak is assessed more practically and more accurately. And that's the reason the scores are accepted worldwide. So now here I mentioned fair to test takers, which means your experience of taking this test anywhere in this world will remain the same. As I said, we have set the standards so high and it's so stringently followed worldwide that you take this test in Chennai, Kolkata, Cairo, Egypt, wherever you want to take this test, you can take this test. But your experience, your customer journey of taking this test will remain the same. The test exactly begins at 1 p.m. in the afternoon India time, because it's 9 a.m. UTC. That's how it is all over the world. So the standards are set so high and it's very stringently followed. So now moving on to the facts and figures. I was telling you about 10,000 organizations in 140 countries. Let's look at some of them. So if you take USA for instance, 3,400 plus institutions in the US accept IELTS. So if you're looking for a career abroad in the US, this is the test that you will need to take. All top colleges, all top Ivy League colleges and four-year institutions in the US accept IELTS. So now you have all the big names here, Massachusetts, Harvard, Chicago, Columbia University. All these universities, you will need an IELTS score to go through, get into these universities. So now, moving on to Canada, the most desired destination abroad in recent times. If you are looking for a life in Canada, this is the test that you will have to take because this is the only test accepted by the Immigration of Canada and the Quebec. Okay? And UK, if UK is your destination, no questions asked. This is the only test accepted by the UK Home Office. So you will need to take an IELTS to go to UK. All top colleges and universities in the Australia and New Zealand accept IELTS as well. So we conduct this test in more than 1,100 testing locations worldwide in 140 countries. It's not that you can take this test whenever you want. There are 48 fixed test dates. There are 4 test dates in a month. In Chennai, it's conducted 4 times in a month. So you have to choose the date, book the exam to take this test. So when you book the test, you will only see the centers. So 1,100 testing locations, which is centers, between Chennai is the center, Coimbatore is the center, Madurai is the center, Tiruchi is the center. You will not know where exactly the test is being held. That information will come to you only 5 days prior to the test days because of the security and the operational reasons. So only 5 days before, it will be held in big hotels in and around the city. So you will get to know the venue of your test only 5 days before the test. You can book the test even 6 months before the actual date. For a test date in December, now today you can go and book a test. If you want to take up the test in December. Okay, before 6 months you can book the test, but however only 5 days before you will know where the test is being held. You will book it as Chennai or Coimbatore. You will just choose the testing location. So now moving on, am I fast guys? Okay, good to go? Okay. Now moving on to the test format. There are 2 modules of this test. One is called the academic and second one is called the general training. Academic, as the name suggests, it is for students like you. If you wish to study abroad, if your purpose of going abroad is to study, then you will have to take this module. And general training is for people who want to migrate and work abroad. So if your purpose of going abroad is to live in that country or to work in that country, you will have to take this general training module. However, your receiving institution decides that. Your band score, your minimum band score and the module of the test is decided by the receiving institution, which means the organization that is offering you the job or the university that is offering you the course, they will tell you whether you need to take an IELTS academic or an IELTS general module. Okay? So if you check the criteria, eligibility criteria for that particular university, they will tell you whether you need to take an IELTS academic, they will say IELTS academic score of band score this and above. So that is how the eligibility criteria are set. So before booking the test, you will need to check which module you need to take. So this is the format of the test. The entire test is for 2.5 hours. The first 30 minutes is the listening. A CD will be played in common. You will be given individual headphones to listen. And at the end of the 30 minutes, you are given a 10 minute transfer time to transfer your answers from the answer sheet to the QMRS. And academic reading and academic general module reading is again for 60 minutes, 1 hour. It's the second module, the second session of the test is reading. this for 1 hour. It has 3 tasks and 40 questions. And then comes the academic writing, which is again for an hour and it has 2 tasks. Speaking is conducted on a different day. Speaking does not happen on the same day. The day that you book the test, the LRW, which is the listening, reading and writing, is conducted. Whereas the speaking happens on a different day. It could be 7 days before the test date or 7 days after the test date. Okay? And the speaking is a one-on-one with an examiner, which will last only for 11 to 14 minutes. So, now we are talking about the two different modules, the academic and the general module. So, the difference between the modules lie in the academic reading and the writing tasks. Okay? Say for example, in an academic writing task, you might be asked to define a pie diagram, a graph, or a bar diagram. You might be asked to explain a compare and contrast, or explain a pie diagram or a chart. Whereas in a general training, you might be asked to write a letter, a formal or an informal letter, which is more relevant to living in that country. So the purpose of both the modules are different. Academic is for students. So the writing task will be more related for being a student abroad, which will ask you to explain some graph or chart. Whereas a general module writing will ask you to write a letter, which is more relevant to living in that country. Yeah? Shall we move on? Am I fast? Good to go? Okay. So I was also talking about the band score. You're getting a band score for each task and the overall band score. This is how you assess. This is called the CEFR, Common European Framework for Reference. So this is how you assess. There is no pass or fail in this exam. So if you get a band score of 5, you'll be looked at as a modest user who's able to manage with your language skills. If you get a band score of 7, you'll be looked at as a good user with good control over the language. Moving on, I'm going to tell you what is expected from you in each of these sections. So why is this test connected and what is expected? So if you have to crack listening, if you have to get good marks, good score in listening, if you have to go get good scores in writing, you need to know what is expected from you, right? So if you don't know what is expected, what they are looking for in your answer sheet, you will not be able to answer that. So pay attention to this section. It will tell you what is expected from you in each module of this test. Listening, as I told you, is for 30 minutes, has 4 sections, has 40 questions in total. The main criteria is there's no negative marking, so you'll have to answer all the questions. So what are the main skills that is targeted? So what does the examiner look for in your answer sheet? Is if you understand the main ideas and specific factual information. So the audio will be different accent. It will have Canadian accent, it will have Australian accent, it will have UK accent or US accent. So they will try to find out if you are able to listen and understand these different accents. If you are able to understand the numbers that they pronounce. If you are able to understand the main idea of what the speaker is telling you. So that is expected out of your listening section. And recognize opinions, attitudes and the purpose of speaker. So there's an audio which plays wherein there will be two people talking or discussing about something and you listen to that and there are questions in your question paper and you answer that. So what is expected is if you are able to understand what the speaker is trying to tell. Moving on, the reading section has 40 questions, 3 sections. Okay, it differs for both academic and the general training. And the main skills targeted are reading for the main ideas and for the details. So it's like a comprehension that we've done in school all our life. So every standard of school has a different comprehension, right? So the 3 tasks will differ in the difficulty. It will have a chart, whereas in general training, you'll be asked to write a letter, a formal or an informal letter. And the task 2 is same for both the modules, where you will have to write an essay, not minimum of 250 words. So now, when the examiner is correcting your writing paper, what is the examiner expecting out of you? These are the points. If you have responded to what they have asked, is there a task response? And then coherence and cohesion. Does anyone know what is coherence? What is coherence? Coherence is nothing but relevance. If you are able to say, for example, they ask me about a cow and you write about an aeroplane, is it related to each other? No, right? So if you are able to write related to the topic, how well you are able to relate, how relevant you are in your answers. So they look for coherence and cohesion. How well is your lexical resource? Lexical resource is nothing but your vocabulary. How good you are able to use new vocabulary, how good you are able to use new words. And also your grammatical range and accuracy. How good are you in your grammar? If you are able to use it at the proper place. Okay? So your grammatical range and accuracy is also looked at. So these are the band descriptors for your writing task. So when you prepare for the test, if you concentrate on this, if you concentrate on improving your grammar, concentrate on improving your vocabulary, and then if you concentrate on writing relevant to what the topic is being asked, then you get a good score in writing. So now moving on to the speaking session, as I told you, it's a one-on-one with the speaker. It will not last more than 11 to 14 minutes. The first is the interview and introduction. So you'll be welcomed by an examiner. They'll tell you the whole interview is being recorded, and then they'll start the interview. So the second part is called individual long term, wherein you are given a topic, a cue card, and you are asked to prepare on that. Okay? So you'll be given a minute to prepare on the topic, after which you will have to speak for 2-3 minutes. So whatever you speak is being recorded, and you assist on how you speak. The third one is called a two-way discussion, which is a continuation of what you spoke in the part two. Say for example, the examiner asks you, what was the most unforgettable experience in your life? And you tell them a story about how you saved, let's say you saved a puppy, a dog on the road, which was hit by a car. You tell them some story. The third part will be the examiner will ask you probe questions. Guys, can I have some attention please? This is practicing. Thank you. So the third part will be an extension of what you spoke in part two. So they will probe and ask you questions which you will need to answer. Yeah? So these are the band descriptors for speaking. So what does the examiner look for when you speak? They look for how fluent and how relevant are you. So you're talking about a topic, how fluent are you, how fluent your thought flow is, how are you able to relate to the topic, that's what they look at. And of course your vocabulary, grammar and pronunciation, how you pronounce the words also matters. So now that's it about the I've told you about the modules of this test. I've told you about the different elements that we test. So now moving on, once you register for the test with British Council, the British Council offers lots and lots of resources for you to prepare for this test. Okay? Let's have a look at it. So, once you, excuse me guys, can I have your attention please? I'm hearing a lot of noise, so kind of, if you could maintain silence, it would be great. Thank you. So these are the resources that British Council offers when you book the test. One is the test prep book. You get a mock book which will help you prepare for all the modules. Then you have something called as Road to IELTS, which is a 30-hour intensive course, online course, to which you have provided free access. This course is designed by British Council trainers and experts. So this course will help you prepare for all the four skills of the test. Then we also have a 6-week course called Understanding IELTS, the massive open online course, MOOCs Understanding IELTS. We give you free access to this, and this again will help you prepare for all the 4 modules of this test. And we have a YouTube channel called as Take IELTS. So you could just go to the YouTube and click Type in British Council Take IELTS. You will find lots and lots of videos which will help you prepare for this test. This is the latest addition to our resource pool, which is called the IELTS Prep app. This can be downloaded on your iOS as well as Android phones. It's free of cost. And this app will help you prepare for your vocabulary and grammar. Okay, now I have a small video for you. This is from one of our test takers, Sain Das, who is now in the Pace University Law School. Let's hear it from her. Lovely. Thank you so much for your patience. And any questions that you